Right, folks, a bit of a video demo on a flight case, and it's that one there. It's from a company called Roadready. Now, first of all, I'm going to go over there and tell you the exact number of it. It is RR2XT160CSC, and I'll put that in the actual description. Right, got a couple of speakers on the top. Now, again, I am not telling you to do this. I'm basically sort of a little bit of advice, and also what, let's say, a DJ, a roadie, someone in a band or something like that would quite often do. You've got your flight case, at the end of the day you've got a bit of space on the top. There's no point just wheeling something like that in. You might as well put something on the top and wheel that in while you're wheeling your flight case in with items inside your flight case. In other words, I've saved myself possibly two journeys there. But bearing in mind, always be very careful that the items on the top of the flight case are totally and utterly secure and they're not going to fall off. If you think they're going to fall off, don't do it. On the other hand, if you think they're going to fall off, but there's a mate up the road there smoking a cigarette and twiddling with these bits, then maybe you could ask him to help you. All right, one person in the front, one person in the back, holding on to the likes of a handle here. I think there's one there, yeah. It's a springy thingy. And one hand on the top, and there you go. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these speakers off. One there. Put on my bloody toe. And one there. Right, so there it is. In all its glory. Alright, what have we got? We've got a couple of handles. One, two. We've got a couple of these guys here, butterfly clips. And I don't know if you can notice, but it's got some holes in it. Well, not holes, there's some indentations there. Can you see them? Well, now then, that's not rocket science, but let's be honest. Let's say you've only got a small amount of space and you've got half a dozen of these, you can stack them because the wheels from the one on top fit in there. Therefore, it's not going to go anywhere. Also, two of the wheels have got these little mechanisms which you press down and they lock them in place. So, right, now there it is. Now again, what would you expect to find in a flight case? What can you put inside a flight case? Well, you can put a drinky cup, maybe a hat, some secateurs, or maybe even a pink elephant outfit. Just kidding. All right, so what's this one for? Right, I'll tell you what it is. I've got in here a couple of American DJ X-Move LEDs, two of those in one side, and just put that in there. On the other side, I've just put those just for safekeeping. Those are the items that you fit on the top of your tripod. And then on the other side, I've got two of these, the X-Move laser. There you go. Right, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to take the camera off the tripod and show you the inside. Now I will do another video on this and explain to you exactly, hold on, let's just turn that the other way around. Punk TV guys, no editing, real life. Yeah, how it should be. Right, what I'll do now, I'll take the, I've got the cable at the moment plugged in as well to the camera because the battery's knackered. All right, so there you go. All right, you can see it's well lined. There's loads of space. I mean, the one thing I will highly recommend, which you shouldn't do, is turn this upside down, back to front on its side. If you're gonna use it, wheel it around, make sure it's flat like that. Therefore, the items inside will not fall all over the place. All right, so there you go. Now, video number one is basically showing you the item. In video number two, I'm gonna show you, as daft as it sounds, how to put the wheels on and what they're all about underneath there. It's not a case of, you know, just, quickly like putting one bolt in and one bolt out. There's a certain amount of logic there, but if it's done correctly, theoretically, something like that should be wheeling your kit around for absolutely years. So there you go, video number one on this guy from Roadready, all right? And if I have a close-up there, you can see the model number, okay? So, look, that's been out. Gone a bit blurry. There it is. Practice and enjoy. Thank you very much.